The Vim Airline plugin is a colorful status line for Vim, and we're looking at a PNG picture of it right now. When this picture was taken, we were in the normal mode, and we were editing the sqlite-update.pl program, which is a Perl program. And there's some more information to the right about where we are in the document. And this is what we are going to install in this video. We are going to start off by updating our vimrc file. So I will type vim.vimrc. Inside here, I've already added the code, and I've copied those lines for the plugin from the vimawesome.com website. I'm going to go down and uncomment what I've added in. We need to write this, then go back in, and now we can install this with plug install. I'm going to quit out of the Vim plug installer window, and we see that we have our airline already installed. There we are in normal mode. We're editing the vimrc file, and it's a vim file, but we don't have any color to this. To get the color to work, I'm going to add a line to our vimrc file. And what I'm going to add in is set T underscore uppercase CO equals 256. We will write this out and go back in. And now we've got some color to our airline status bar, but we're still missing those little arrows. To get those arrows to show up, we need to turn on the powerline fonts. So I'm going to add another line, let G colon airline powerline fonts equal 1. Let's write and quit this. And going back in, now instead of the arrows, it looks almost worse. So it's trying to use the airline powerline fonts, but we don't have any fonts in there. One thing people do to add in those arrows is to add in some Unicode symbols, and the symbols would look like this. Let's write and quit this and go back in and see how it looks. And we do have the arrows, but they don't look quite as we were expecting. So I'm going to delete those lines out with 5 uppercase D, and let's write and quit that. To get the characters to look really well, we need to go in and add in a font. So let's go to the Vim Airline GitHub page, and I'm going to look for fonts. And we see some there in features, going to the next one. Here we see integrating with Powerline fonts, and we can download our fonts right here, Powerline fonts. And I am going to download the zip file. I'm going to open up another terminal and go into the download file with CD downloads. And let's see what's in the file with ls. We only have the one zip file. Let's unzip that. And I'm using tab to autocomplete. Checking what's in the file again. Now we've got the fonts master directory that we just unzipped. Let's cd into the fonts master file and list what's in there with ls. And there we see install.sh. To run this, I need to type dot for in this directory, then a slash, and then the file name that we want to run. In this case, install.sh. And it has installed our Powerline fonts, installed to home, Michael, local, share fonts. Now going back into Vim, we want to change our font. And to do that, I'm going to edit, profile preferences, and I'm going to change the font to, I need to uncheck the use system default, and I'm going to change this to hacked. And there it is, hack regular. And there we have our colorful Vim Airline status bar. When we go into insert mode by pressing I, we see it changes to insert mode. Escape takes us back. When we go into visual mode by pressing V, we see we're in visual mode. It also has visual line mode by pressing Shift V and visual block mode with Control V. I have one more Vim tutorial in this series, and it will be about using Vim for comparing two files. In the next video, the last in this series, we'll look at Vim diff.